Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have studied or we have did a numerical which was based on Faraday's first law. So now what we are going to do is we are going to do the same kind of numerical but with of different data. So let us see how can we solve it. So as the question is given on your screen, it says that an electrolytic cell consists of AlCl3 solution while the other consists of ZnSO4 solution and that the both are connected in series. And here the word is in series, so means it's a very logical thing that we are talking about the Faraday's second law of electrolysis. So if same amount of electricity is passed through the cell, calculate the amount of zinc deposited if 1.2 gram of aluminium is deposited in the cell of AlCl3. And here the data has also been they have provided, that is molecular weight of aluminium and molecular weight of zinc is also been provided to us. So let us first of all do, we have to determine what are the data that are present in the given question. So we have to extract the data and then only we could solve the further part. So the given data has the values where the amount of Al, the amount of aluminium is being present. So therefore the amount, that is weight, mass of aluminium is being provided as 1.2 gram while that of mass of zinc is not provided and we have to calculate the mass of zinc and the molecular mass of aluminium is given as 27 gram per mole while that of molecular mass of zinc is given as 65.4 gram per mole. So this is the molecular mass and the mass of the aluminium that they have provided to us. So with the help of this data, the first thing that we have going to do is we are going to calculate what would be the number of moles of copper or what would be the number of moles of aluminium or whatever the data that they have provided us. So in this case, they have provided us the mass of aluminium. So the as well as the molar mass of aluminium. So by this data, we could calculate what would be the molar mass of or what would be the number of moles of aluminium present in this amount of weight. So let us calculate the first what would be the number of moles of aluminium. So therefore, the number of moles of aluminium can be calculated as, I would write it as N of Al. This N represents the number of moles of aluminium, which is equals to weight or mass of aluminium divided by the molar mass of aluminium. So the weight of aluminium which was provided to us was 1.2 gram while that of the molar mass of aluminium which was provided as 27. So let us see what would be the answer. So the answer is 0.044 moles of aluminium that is present in a weight of 1.2 gram of aluminium. So this has been calculated, but we cannot calculate what would be the number of moles of zinc because the mass is not being provided to us and that is what we have to calculate. So now because of this data that they have provided us, we could estimate what would be the number of moles of zinc by applying the law of Faraday's second law. So let us see how can we apply it. So before that we have to know what is mole ratio and how can we calculate the mole ratio. So let us see. So for mole ratio, it has a formula. The mole of substance deposited divided by the number of electrons required during the process to get deposited for the ions that would be cation basically. So therefore the divided by the number of moles involved in that half reaction. So in this case we could calculate the mole ratio for aluminum also, as well as the mole ratio for zinc also. So first of all, let us see what would be the mole ratio of aluminum. And since aluminum is being present or aluminum is being abstracted from the solution which contains AlCl3, so therefore the AlCl3 ions will accept few electrons to get deposited on the electrode. So therefore if AlCl3 get dissociated, it forms Al3+, and this Al3+ will accept 3 electrons to form solid aluminium. So in this case, for producing the 1 mole of aluminium, the 3 electrons are being required in this process. So therefore the mole ratio of the aluminium can be written as 1 mole of substance that is been deposited, that is 1 mole in this case, and the number of electrons that are being required in the this half cell reaction is nothing but 3, or 3 moles of electron. So by the help of this we could calculate what would be the mole ratio for zinc also. So let us calculate what would be the mole ratio of zinc. But let me tell you, zinc is present in ZnSO4 solution. So if ZnSO4 gets dissociated, it will form Zn2+, and now this Zn2+ will accept 2 electrons to form solid zinc that would get deposited on the particular electrode. So therefore the mole ratio of zinc is nothing but the number of moles of zinc that has been produced in 1 mole, that is 1 mole of zinc, divided by the number of electrons that are being involved in this reaction. So in this reaction the number of electrons that are being involved is 2. So therefore, so I could relate, so this are the data that we have got. So now let's see, okay, continue bolna hai aisa chalega. So now let's see how can we calculate the total number of zinc total number of moles of zinc that are being involved in this reaction. So for according to Faraday's second law, the mole ratio the number of moles of zinc, or the number of moles of aluminium, I could write in this way also, divided by the number of moles of zinc is equals to mole ratio of aluminium divided by the mole ratio of zinc. So by relating this thing, what we are going to get is the mole ratio of aluminium, which was, or the number of moles of aluminium that we have calculated, was found to be 0.044 moles, divided by the number of moles of zinc is not been calculated yet, so I would write it as number of moles of zinc, in which the mole ratio of aluminium was been calculated as 1 mole of zinc, that is 1 mole of aluminium divided by 3 electrons, the whole divided by, for zinc I could say as 1 mole of zinc involved 2 electrons. So this whole equation can be written as 1 mole of aluminium divided by 3 into 2 divided by 1 mole of. So therefore 2 divided by 1 mole of zinc. So therefore the answer that we could get is, since 1 mole of aluminium will be having the same amount of the molecular weight of aluminium, and that of 1 mole of zinc will also contains the molecular weight of zinc. So therefore what the thing that we could write it as, we could write it in this way, that is 0.044 into the number of moles of zinc into 2 divided by 3. So therefore the number of moles of zinc will be equals to 0.044 into 3 divided by 2. So let us see what would be the answer for this. It is 0.066 moles of zinc that has been deposited on the cell where ZnSO4 is present. But because of this data, we could calculate what would be the number or what could be the weight or what could be the mass of the zinc that has been deposited. Since we know the formula, N of Zn is nothing but weight of Zn divided by molecular weight of Zn. So therefore the number of moles of zinc that has been we have calculated right now is 0.066 into the weight, which is not known to us right now, and the molecular weight of zinc, which is found to be 65.4. so therefore the weight of Zn is equals to 0.066 into 65.4, which means it will give an answer of 4.3164 gram. So this is how we have calculated the weight of zinc with, which is connected in series when AlCl3 solution and ZnSO4 solution are connected in series, and by the help of Faraday's second law we have calculated what is the weight of zinc that has been deposited. So it was so much simple to calculate this kind of answer. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video, and please subscribe Ekeeda channel and share this with your friends. Thank you.